GEO600 is an interferometric gravitational wave detector, which is located in Rute near Saarstedt, close to Hannover.
Which is run by a collaboration of the University of Glasgow, of the University of Hanover, of the Max Planck Society in Germany, and of the University of Birmingham and Cardiff.
GEO600 is special because it's a small interferometer.
The bigger they are, the more sensitive they are. It costs a lot of money to build very large installations. The biggest of these detectors is around 4 kilometers long.
We had to compensate for that by being maybe a little ingenious in developing some techniques that would make it possible for us to reach sensitivities that are at least comparable to the large-scale detectors.
GEO600 was always a mix of a data-taking instrument and a think tank, so producing innovative technologies.
One of the main features and real features of GEO is also the quality of the laser, which was developed in Hanover. And that laser development in Hanover has led to Hanover actually providing the laser systems for Advanced LIGO.
The suspensions for the mirror is an example, the monolithic suspensions, signal recycling, the laser system. There are many developments.
The mirrors are suspended not with steel wires, but with glass fibers, and this helps to reduce noise.
Almost every part of GEO has been exported to take on an important role in Advanced LIGO one way or another.
GEO600 is important because it demonstrated some key technologies which have been vital for the upgrade of other detectors around the world.
We have as the only currently operating gravitational wave detector, a squeezed light source.
To improve the sensitivity of the detector by factors of a few, and that is a technology that in the future will probably be standard also in the other large interferometers in the world.
Small detector, a small team is only there at the site, and it's very kind of familiar to operate it.
Everyday business is mainly watching the system and understanding when something goes wrong. GEO600 is almost fully automatic. It aligns itself, it brings itself to the right state of operation, and when some of the control systems fall out of lock, in many cases, the instrument is able to bring itself back to a good operating state.